first. Okay.
Hey there, I'm Megan Nodecker. I'm a knitting pattern designer from Abbotsford, BC.
And I'm Katie, Megan's sister, and I'm a graphic designer. I live in Vancouver.
Pin Pin is our knitting pattern company, and I design the patterns, and I write the patterns, and do all of the knitting.
And I work behind the scenes. I do the pattern, like, layout design, so if you're downloading a PDF, I made that for you. and I we sort of do photography together, and I do a lot of the photo editing, and I'm also really interested in when we do, like, booth design. I get super into that. but I don't do any knitting, and I also don't write patterns. The concept for the book that we're working on right now came from sort of where we were as a company 10 years ago, how we started. When we started Pip and Pin, we both knit, and we knit using big chunky wools. We knit cowls and big scarves and headbands, and we went to craft markets and sold all our knitwares. Then we had children, and so that was impossible. And that's when the company sort of shifted to Megan becoming a pattern designer and I being on the back end of things. I really wanted to write this book because all of our patterns previously that we started with were quite easy and, like, beginner patterns. And for someone like myself who isn't a very advanced knitter, like, that is obviously very appealing because I can't even knit anything Megan designs. So I kind of wanted us to have a book that sort of was the beginning of us. And then, of course, we'll never have one of these books again because it will be all patterns that I can't knit. but it's kind of nice to start, like, where we started.
We started Pip and Pin in 2010. We had inherited a bunch of yarn from our grandma. She was a very avid knitter and had a big giant collection of wool and things that that we got from her. And at the time, neither of us were really great knitters, and we wanted to use some of this yarn in a different way. So what we started doing is combining a bunch of different strands of yarn and making simple, like, button cowls. So the star wasn't the pattern, it was more about the yarns that we used and the combinations that we used and being able to make something really unique with the things that we had. What I remember is, like, you coming home one day and you had this purple and white, like, kind of checkerboard scarf that you had done.
Yeah.
And it was all grandma's yarn, and you used, like, multiple strands and you knit them all together, and it was something totally different than I had, like, ever seen.
Yeah. And I didn't use a pattern because I didn't even know they existed.
No, you just, like, did it. Yeah. And then I think it was that night we decided to go to Michael's.
You had said, oh, hey, I know this new company called Etsy.
Yeah.
And I bet you could sell this online. And then I was like, oh, okay, sure. And I was in my graphic design program.
Yeah.
So then I was like, oh, I can brand our company. How exciting. So it was just like this fun little project that we started together just by, like, me knitting essentially to relax because I was, like,
you were in the middle of school.
Yeah. And it was, like, so much going on, and I just found it relaxing. And then, yeah, you were like, let's open a Etsy shop.
New thing called Etsy. I remember when we were at our very first Knit City in Vancouver, and it was very, very small, and like nobody really knew about it yet. It was the first year and we were still making our button cowls and we were still, you know, just selling the physical things. And our booth was right next to Tin Can Knits, who is a very, very well-known knitting pattern designer team. And so we were beside their booth. And I think that was the first time that I realized, like, hey, there's knitting patterns out there and people make those knitting patterns. So that was really like enlightening.
You bought the pattern for that book with the circles.
The pop blanket.
Pop blanket.
Yeah. 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 And I made that blanket. I love that blanket. Yeah. But that was the first time, like, I think either of us ever really realized that, hey, people are actually, like, it's somebody's job to make these patterns. So if you've ever knit a large amount very quickly, you realize how hard it is on your body. So we decided to, take Pip and Pin in a little bit of a different direction and start creating the knitting patterns together.
One thing also that made me want to create patterns for, like, these really easy things, like, in the very beginning all our patterns were, like, super easy.
Yeah.
But something that made me want to create those patterns was because we've been to Knit City every year since it started, and always there's a friend that comes with, like, a knitter, you know? Like you bring your friend because they really like yarn and they like knitted stuff, but they don't know how to knit, and they're trying to learn. And I would always talk to these girls, and they, you know, it was even when we had patterns, and they're like, oh, you know, I don't really know what I'm doing. And, like, that's how I feel. I don't know what I'm doing. So I felt like it was important to have easy things, too, so someone can feel like, hey, I can do this. Like, it's a good way to learn. And it's, like, something, you know, it's not, like, just knitting those dish towels, right? It's, like, it's kind of boring. So you can knit this, like, beautiful Scott, like, cowl,
yeah, or things that you're actually gonna wear.
And it's, like, a really great feeling when you're, like, don't know what you're doing yet and you're just learning, and then you can, like, create this thing that's really beautiful. So I don't know, that's why I wanted to make those patterns, even though they're super easy and, like, a lot of expert knitters would come and be like, well, you can just knit this in an hour.
Like, which is
true.
Yes.
You can. Yes.
But the other...
We should cut that out.
Well no, because the other part of that book, like, the second part of the book is kind of, yes, the patterns are, like, more beginner, but we're also going to include things for more experienced knitters. Like, I enjoy knitting these patterns because you get to play. You get to combine different yarns. It doesn't matter if they don't have to be all wool. They don't have to be all this, all that. Like, you just take what you have or beautiful combinations of different things and experiment. And you can play a lot more, I feel, than you would a typical knitting pattern. You don't need, you know, gauge. Gauge is not a thing. And neither is swatching. And, like, they're such small projects that you kind of just do them as, like, you figure all that stuff out along the way. So I think the book is great for beginners, and it's also good for more experienced knitters who just want a little guidance when it comes to kind of knitting outside the box, like going outside of the pattern and just playing a little more with yarn.
Yeah.
It's not so structured.
Yeah. Because you don't have to feel so committed to something. Like, I understand how much work goes into a lot of knitting patterns, and they're so detailed and beautiful and ornate. You wouldn't want to, like, veer from the pattern because, you know, you just want this thing to be amazing.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, these, it's so easy and fast. So you can really, like, experiment and be creative and make a mistake. It doesn't matter, because it's just fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and too, it's very easy to, like, in the first, 20 minutes of knitting it, or the first, 3 inches, which is about 4 rows in most of the patterns, you know whether you need to add more yarn or use smaller needles or, alter it, or one of your colors isn't quite right, so switch out one of your colors or something like that. Like, you know really, really fast whether it's going to work or not.
Yeah.
So then you can switch it up.
Yeah. The patterns, because we've sort of revamped.
Yeah.
Like, we've kind of revamped our our first patterns. So our like
the button cowl, the easy bow headband. The woodcutter gloves.
And then we've thrown in a few new ones, like a really easy sweater
And a blanket. Oh my goodness, this blanket.
So amazing.
So we are gonna have this book released for Knit City this year, so in end of September 2018, and we'll be having the physical copies of the book printed, and then we'll also have digital downloads as well, which will probably be available on Ravelry as well as our website. And so we would really, really love your support for this project. We are both super excited about it, and we can't wait to get started with the photo editing and the layout of the book and make this thing just come to life. Yeah. And we really need your help. Thank you in advance to anyone who is able to support us. So thanks. Thank you so much. Bye.